your pilot is Sonal, co-pilot is Manveer, and crew member is Anjani. So over to you, Sonal.
Let's get started with our today's session.
Good afternoon, guests. I hope you all are doing good. So today we'll be visiting United States of America. I hope you all know that United States of America is the superpower of the world. Knowing about the geographic location of United States of America, so it is the world's fourth largest country in size, located in North America. The country is bordered on the west by the Pacific Ocean and to the east by the Atlantic Ocean. Along the northern border is Canada and the southern border is Mexico. There are 50 states and the District of Columbia. More than twice the size of the European Union, the United States has high mountains in the west and is a vast central plain. The lowest point in the country is in Death Valley, which is at minus 282 feet, which is around minus 86 meters. And the highest peak is Denali, which is Mount McKinley at 2,320 feet, which is around 6,198 meters. The capital. So Washington, D.C. D.C. in full, District of Columbia, city and capital of the United States of America. It is coextensive with the District of Columbia and is located on the northern shore of the Potomac River at the river's navigation head, that is the transshipment between waterway and land transport. The state of Maryland borders the District of Columbia to the north, east, and west, and the state of Virginia borders the district on the southern shore of the Potomac River. Washington is an extraordinary city, one with the multiple personalities, a working federal city, an international metropolis, a picturesque tourist. Good afternoon, Sneha. An unmatched treasury of the country's history and artifacts, and a cosmopolitan center that retains a neighborly small town ambience. The role Washington plays as the capital of the United States often overshadowed its lively local history and its complex political, economic, and social issues. About half of the land in Washington is owned by US government, which pays no taxes on it. Several hundred thousand people in the DC metropolitan area work for the federal government. Now I want you to view a video. Proceed to the presentation.
Comprised of 50 states, the USA
is the national flag of the United. It consists of 13 equal horizontal strips of red, top and bottom, alternating with white, with a blue rectangle in the canton referred to specifically as the Union, bearing 50 small white five-pointed stars.
Baby.
horizontal rows with the rows colonies that declared independence from the Kingdom of Great Britain and became the first states in the US. Nicknames for the flag include the Stars and Stripes Old Glory and the Star Spangled Banner. Now let's know about the history of the flag. The current design of the US flag is its 27th. The design of the flag has been modified officially 26 times since 1777. The 48 star flag was in effect for 47 years until the 49 star version became official on July 4, 1959. The 50 star flag was ordered by then President Eisenhower on August 21, 1959 and was adopted in July 1960. It is the longest used version of the US flag and has been in use for over 61 years. The mother language of USA is English. Now let's know about the currency. The currency in the USA is called the dollar. American paper currency is issued in several denominations: $1, $2, $5, $100, $20, $50, and $100. Coins are also of several denominations, with the most common being 1 cent, 5 cents, 10 cents, 25 cents, 50 cents, and again $1. So $1 is equal to 75 INR approximately. Let's know about the history of USA, because we all know that the USA country is the superpower of the world, but how it became? For centuries, native peoples lived across the vast expanse that would become the United States of America. In the early 17th century, settlers moved from Europe to the New World, established colonies, and displaced the native peoples. The settlers fought for their independence from Britain in the late 18th century and formed a union of states based on a new constitution. The nation continued to expand westward, and although the country is a relatively young nation, it has become a global power since declaring independence from Britain on July 4, 1776. US government and economy. Citizens over the age of 18 years old vote to elect the President and Vice President of the United States every 4 years. The President lives in the White House and the capital city of Washington, D.C. The part of the government that makes the country's law, controls the money, and decides if the USA should go to war is called the Congress. There are two houses of Congress.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Oh, ma'am, sorry, I'm late because I had some technical issue.
Nessa, my crew member will provide you the recording.
Okay, ma'am, thank you.
The two houses of Congress, the Senate and the House of Representatives. The Senate has 100 members, two from each of the 50 states, and each serves a 6-year term. The House of Representatives is made up of 435 representatives who must be elected every 2 years. The Supreme Court is the branch of the government that interprets the laws of the USA. It is the highest court in the country and made up of 9 justices who are each picked by the president and must be approved by Congress. So recently, USA got its new president and vice president. Hope we all know Joe Biden is the president and Kamala Harris is the vice president, the first Indian black president of the USA. The president of United States is the head of the state and the head of the government of the United States of America. The president directs the executive branch of the federal government and is the commander in chief of the United States Armed Forces. So the picture displayed here on the screen is the stamp of the president. Let's know about the national symbol of the nation. The national bird is bald eagle. National sport is baseball. National tree is oak. And national monument is Statue of Liberty. The airlines.
Statue of Liberty.
Yes.
And so that's Visa of USA also.
Yes. The first one is Alaska Airlines. It is a major American airline headquartered in SeaTac, Washington. Within the Seattle metropolitan area, it is the fifth largest airline in the United States when measured by fleet size, scheduled passenger carried, and the number of destinations served. Alaska, together with its regional partners, Horizon Air, SkyWest Airlines, operate a large domestic route network, primarily focused on connecting from the Pacific Northwest, West Coast, and Alaska to over 100 destinations in the contiguous United States, Hawaii, Belize, Canada, Costa Rica, and Mexico. The next one is Allegiant Airlines. So Allegiant Air is an American ultra-low-cost airline that operates scheduled and charter flights. As a major air carrier, it is the 14th largest commercial airline in North America. It was founded in 1997 as WestJet Express. It is wholly owned by Allegiant Travel Company, a publicly traded company with 4,000 employees and over $2.6 billion market capitalization. The corporate headquarters are in Summerlin, Nevada, a suburb of Las Vegas. The next is American Airlines, which is a major headquartered in Fort Worth, Texas, within the Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex. It is the world's largest airline when measured by fleet size, scheduled passengers carried, and revenue passengers mile. American, together with its regional partners, operates an extensive international and domestic network with almost 6,800 flights per day to nearly 350 destinations in more than 50 countries. American Airlines is a founding member of the One World Alliance, the third largest alliance in the world. Regional service is operated by independent and subsidiary carriers under the brand name American Eagle. The next is Delta Airlines, which is typically referred to as Delta, is one of the major airlines of the United States, a legacy carrier. It is headquartered in Atlanta, Georgia. The airline, along with its subsidiaries and regional affiliates, including Delta Connection, operates over 5,400 flights daily and serves 325 destinations in 52 countries on 6 continents. Delta is a founding member of the SkyTeam Airline Alliance. Delta has 9 hubs, with Atlanta being its largest in terms of total passengers and number of departures. It is ranked second among the world's largest airlines by number of scheduled passengers carried, revenue passenger kilometers flown, and fleet size. It is ranked 69th on the Fortune 500. The company's slogan is "Keep Climbing." Let's talk about the cuisines. So first one is buffalo chicken wings. So let me tell you about this. So buffalo chicken wings, all created in the 1960, fried chicken wings doused in a cayenne vinegar hot sauce.
Ma'am, what is this Reuben sandwich?
I'll tell you about this.
Okay, ma'am.
Now let's talk about hot dogs. Nothing complements a summer cookout or a baseball game better than all American hot dog. All the creation is credited to the German Charles Feltman, who used buns to serve German sausage to save on plates. It was Polish immigrant who actually, his name was Nathan Handwerker's hot dog stand, Nathan on Coney Island, that turned hot dog into national icon. There are regional variations of it, for example, New York style with ketchup and the relish.
Hot dog.
And Chicago style.
I like hot dog.
Very good, Nissa. Chicago style served as a poppy seed bun with absolutely no ketchup. The next is meatloaf. So comfort food at its best, most American households would have family recipe for their version. Typically, it involves ground meat and a seasoning made into a loaf shape, either using a loaf pan or hand shaped roasted, and then topped with sauce of just ketchup. Meatloaf will usually take Americans right back to their mother's kitchen. Now, next is hamburger. The popularity of the hamburger and cheeseburger in the USA is indisputable. So traditional gourmet fast food with bacon, sliders with green chili, Juicy Lucy style, the list of variations and toppings is infinite. It is therefore one food which we had to pick burgers that have been most American of them all. So last is Reuben sandwich. The classic corned beef, Swiss cheese and sandwich is synonymous with American delis. This sandwich is known as the American staple sandwich. So let's talk about the most popular festival of the world, Halloween. So October 31 is Halloween and is now celebrated in many countries around the world. But do you know anything about the origin of this scary special day? So it was first founded in Ireland and then it migrated and adopted by United States. The traditions of Halloween on 31st of October comes from the ancient Celtic festival of Samhain. Samhain was the Celtic New Year and they celebrated it on November 1 because that was the end of summer and harvest time and the beginning of winter. It was also the time for gods to return to earth for a day. People lit a big fire, wore special clothes and made of animal skin and hoped to be safe from the ghost and the winter. In AD 609, the Catholic Church put the Christian celebration of All Saints Day on November 1. In AD 1000, the church added All Souls Day on November 2 and Hallows Eve or Halloween moved to the night of the 31st. Now let's know about why they use pumpkin. The cells carve faces into vegetables like turnips, potatoes and squash to scare the ghosts and other spirits and make them go away. It was sometimes called a jack-o'-lantern because of an Irish story about a man Jack. He played a trick on the devil and they had to walk the earth for all time as a punishment. Irish people who came to live in the United States in 1800s found pumpkin much easier to carve and the tradition became what we see today. So I'll show a video which is related to the Halloween and it will give you a better understanding about that.
Ma'am, I saw in some videos that Halloween is very creepy. Like people decorate their houses on Halloween and go to do trick or treat. Oh, Mr. Rhinoceros.
Haven't heard stories from me in a while, right? So, let me tell you the story of Halloween.
Ma'am, you know even I watch Mr. Binox show.
Good. So I hope you now understand why Halloween is celebrated and why do they carve pumpkin. So now. Now we'll see the video about the places to visit.
Can I go to the worship room?
Yeah, you can, yes, sir.
The beach a lot. Yes, ma'am, the beach is so beautiful. The beach was so cool.
Good to know about it. So, thank you so much for being so patient. Indrani, over to you.
Yes. So, you all like that, right?
Indrani, ma'am.
Hi, Nisa. So, tomorrow we are going to visit Vatican City. Okay. If you want to present, You can.
Ma'am, can I present tomorrow?
Sure, Nista.
Bye, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Bye. Thank you.
Can you have a nice day, ma'am?
Sharing screen.
Nice day, too.
Bye, sir. Have a nice day.
Hi, Nisa. Hi, how are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
Good. Shall I? So, how was your trip to US?